jobbing today. It's actually the rear part, like the rack off a motorbike, and they're having trouble bolting the actual, there's a big box that goes on the back of it so they can put storage stuff in it. And there's this actually this plate that goes on first, and when you put the bolt through, they can't put their fingers or spanners in there to hold the nuts, so they can do up the nuts to hold the plate on. So I'm gonna make up some T-nuts, so I'll mill the ends of these out. There's four of them to make, and the T-nut will slide up underneath in the slot there, so that way they can just do up the nut and do up the screw on top. And yeah, they should be able to do up the nuts on top. That way they don't have to put a spanner or nothing underneath. So we'll head over to the mill now, and we'll set this up.
All right, we're over on the mill. First thing I'll do, I'll set it up in the vise. Use an edge finder to find the two edges. I'll use the half function on the DRO, and that'll give me the center. And then it's 15 millimeters from the center each side. And I'll use a 12 millimeter, four fluted end mill, and we'll cut out the solids. So I'll get started on that.
been completed, so they fit in like that. What I'll do now, I'll drill and tap them M6. The way we put this on, I'll bolt that straight down directly to it. So I'll head over to the mill now and I'll drill and tap them. Right, back here on the mill. I've already set it up in the vise and I've put a center drill in it so we know where to start drilling the hole. So now I'll just drill and tap it. Right, I've finished the T-nuts for the motorbike rack. So all I've got to do now is put it on. Once it's on the bike, I won't have to, the actual guard will hold the T-nuts up. So I'll be able to just do it, put it in, do it up. It's all good to go. So on to the next.